Hello Haskellings! Day 9 is upon us, and we can start by reading in the input file, which is a grid of numbers. We will use two new tricks today. One is to use the monkey operator to create a singleton list. In other words, turn a character into a string. The second is to use a type annotation on the read function, which saves us from having to give it a full type signature or otherwise specify the type of its output. This requires the type application's language extension, but because this is so useful and otherwise doesn't impact us, let's put this directly into the makefile. We're going to use a function from last year called mapNeighbors, but there were a few variations, so let's have a look at the Advent of Code module to pick out the right one. So the one we'll need is called mapNeighborsV, which uses a vector of vectors. We can copy over the type signature for reference. To use this function, we need to convert our list of lists to a vector of vectors, specify the neighbors function, and make a mapping function that takes in the cell's value and its neighbors values and returns the new value for this cell. Part 1 requires us to find the cells which have higher numbers in all surrounding cells. So let's map our grid to a grid of maybe int values, with just values representing those that meet this requirement. After converting back to a list of lists, we can concatenate the rows together and filter on the just values with cat maybes. The puzzle asks us to add one to each low point's height before summing them all together. Part 2 is again a lot more challenging. To get the basin sizes, we will calculate the number of cells that flow into each cell, but to do this we need to already have that number for any higher adjacent cells. That means that we'll need to make some changes to the mapNeighbors function to reveal to the mapping function G the results already calculated. We know that this will not cause any cycles, because we always work downwards, so this is safe to do. The first step is to give the resulting grid a name. Then we need to pass the neighbouring results to the function. The get subfunction of mapNeighbors is where the values are being fetched from the input grid, so we just need to get the values from the output grid as well. To avoid code duplication, let's move this to a separate function and use V to represent the grid. Since we're splitting out the tuple in getPrime, we can just use the whole tuples in get and use our num instance for tuples to do the addition. After fetching the value and results, we can bind these to the names VR and VM and return them as a tuple. Because this do block is under the maybe monad, this will return nothing if there's any problem, or just the values, which is why we're using mapMaybe to call it. Because we're returning a tuple here, the signature for the mapping function needs to accept a list of tuples, not two separate lists. This makes sense because each value result pair corresponds to a single cell. The G function can just return the cell value back for now. We have an error because we need to import the data.vector module. And another error because catMaybes needs the values as maybes. And also we're returning VR and VM the wrong way around for the type. That's compiling fine. So let's now remove the stuff from part 1 and write out the type signature for G. We'd like to return the number of cells in the basin so far, but we don't want to include a cell twice. So let's instead return the list of cells so that we can get the unique list later. That also means that the get subfunction of mapNeighbors will need to return the coordinates of the neighbors as well, and we can adjust our type signatures to match. Finally, we get to implement G, which needs firstly to filter out all the neighbors that are not between this cell's value and 9. Next, the result for this cell is the concatenation of all results from the higher cells and the coordinates of those neighbors too. Now that we have our resulting grid, we can concatenate the rows together and use length of group of sort to get the number of unique coordinates. And again, we have to add 1 to these. To get the largest 3, we can sort in descending order and take the product of the first 3, and with that, we're done. So until next time, happy Haskelling!